Hi, this is Pat Love with Pat's Two Cents. I have a serious warning, you guys. Now, I've been watching YouTube, and a lot of times I inform myself as well about these end times events. And one of the things that I have been listening to tonight are things dealing with the CERN thing in Switzerland, what they call the portals of hell. I want you to hear this, because this is a serious warning, you guys. I'm not playing. I'm not trying to be dramatic. I want you to hear this. And I want you to sit down, be still, cut out all of your little distractions. And if you gotta wait till the kids are in bed, listen to this. This is serious. This is why you cannot afford to take the mark of the beast. Now, these are going to be two speakers. The second, I don't know who he is. The first one, I believe, is John Hagee. But I want you to hear what they're saying. John Hagee describes what's going on with CERN. The second man describes how it is in connection with our minds, mind control, and the RFID chip.
What's happening at that collider is an astounding thing. So I want to read something to you this morning from what's called a theoretical physicist. This man, his name is Stephen Hawking. He's well known throughout the world. Anyone that has anything to do with nuclear energy or has anything to do with physics knows this man. And he is one that some rate even on the level of Einstein and of that level. And so I'll read you what this man has to say about what's happening right now in CERN, Switzerland. Listen carefully. These are the words of Stephen Hawking.
Now, I want you to sit down and be still. Get your cup of coffee, go to the bathroom, do whatever you got to do. But sit down. Please pay close attention to this. This is really, really pertinent. You've got to hear this.
He recently warned the reactivation in March of CERN's Large Hadron Collider could pose grave dangers to our planet. The ultimate reality, check, we are warned. Hawking has come straight out and said the God particle, and this is what you've heard referred to time and again as the Higgs boson particle, the God particle found by CERN could destroy the universe. Now let that settle in. This man is an atheist, and he says there is no God. Yet he says that what's happening right now in CERN, Switzerland, has the potential to destroy the universe.
Before we go any further, when he said that, remember the two videos I did dealing with the minds going out of control because of demon possession? Right then, they showed an image of a man grabbing his head and blood oozing out. And you could tell he was like going crazy, just totally insane, instant insanity. Now, I believe, and I felt this coming, that as the demons begin to multiply in these last days on the earth, people are going to start flipping out. Seemingly, for no reason at all, normal working family people going off, totally off. I mean berserk going off. Now, this is why we have to guard our minds and renew our minds. Okay, let me let them do the talking, and then I'll finish with Pat's Two Cents. Crazy.
Lucifer lives in the antimatter. He lives in a different frequency or a different dimension, a spiritual world, a spiritual realm. But he comes in to contact us. He will try to manipulate you. He will try to tempt you by manipulating your brain. This is why the Bible tells us to put on the whole armor of God. And Apostle Paul says, the helmet of salvation. Another scripture he says, put on the mind of Christ. Another scripture says, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Dr. Lester Sumner used to teach us all the time that the mind is the battleground for the soul. So it's the manipulation. And so what they're doing at CERN is the manipulating the darkness, the dark matter. And
you gotta hear this. Stop right here. I'm sorry to keep interrupting, but I know how short our attention spans can be. And you may be thinking about the news, but you got to hear this. This is why you cannot take the mark of the beast.
By the collisions of protons, it's more than just a potential massive earth-changing, universe-changing explosion, but it's a manipulation of the frequencies on which humans on Earth are living. Imagine if you could take everybody under and manipulate the frequencies that we all are operating in into a different dimension or frequency. Imagine if the whole world could be dropped into this hole, into this change of reality, if you will, or dimension. And that's what they're trying to do with the RFID microchip, folks. And now, I'm not a scientist, but the radio frequency identification device is to not just, it's not just to link you to a computer, it's to manipulate your DNA or your mind to bring you a couple frequencies down to where you can be manipulated. The only thing that it won't manipulate, get this, folks, this is great.
Hear this.
Is it can't go through the blood of Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm not joking you. I mean, there's prophecy teams that work for the federal government, and they know this, that they can't manipulate the mind of Christians because it can't get through the blood of Jesus.
Now, right there is the main reason. If you can't think of any other reason, if you can't think of anything wrong with you, that's a good reason right there to give your heart to the Lord. You have supernatural, divine protection, mentally, physically, spiritually. On one of these, there was a man that read a scripture. And in the scripture, he talked about how when Satan was unleashed and he came out from the pit, he would bring all of these demons, and they would be in the form of locusts and scorpions. And they would come out and they would torment people for 5 months. Now, whatever that time span is, you know how it can be very symbolic. But the bottom line is there's torment coming. Didn't we see that in the video where the woman just went off? Now listen, if you've got that going on, the torment, what we don't know until we read the word is that the only people exempt from that torment will be born again Christians. Now you think about that when you consider the possibility. You even consider taking the mark of the beast. That's insanity in and of itself. Don't take the mark. Say this prayer with me. I don't care how much you doubt. I doubted Jesus. I doubted the existence of God when I said this prayer. You say it with me. Father, I ask you in the name of Jesus to forgive me for all my sins. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. Heal my heart, mind, body, and soul. And I pray, Lord, that you protect me, that you grant me your mercy, and that you give me authority over all the works of darkness. Give me a hunger and thirst for righteousness. Give me that new nature. Empower me to live your way. Change my heart so that this will end up being true repentance rather than lip service. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. You're forgiven. Your slate is clean. Welcome to the body of Christ. Whatever you do, I don't care how much of a threat you're looking at. I don't care how afraid you are for you or your kids. Do not take the mark. You will seal you yourself, and you will seal your family to damnation if you encourage them to do so as well. Do not take the mark.